Hey guys, Stealth here. Recently I've been reading the Rainbow Six book by Tom Clancy again, so I was looking forward to some, well, I'm not going to say replication of the actions in the book, but tactical gameplay like that is always interesting. So I decided to dig up Breach and Clear from my Steam library. This game was originally designed for iPad, but they changed it to a port to the PC. And in this Breach and Clear game, you are tasked with commanding a squad of four guys. Now, you yourself can pick what kind of squad you want. I've picked the SEALs because they get a little bit better reaction, so they can acquire their targets a bit faster. You can also create new squads, and with those, you can create the SAS, the JTF2, the KSK, Spetsnaz, and the Rangers. You can change the loadout on any of these guys with any kind of gun, their optics, infrared devices, grips, lights, suppressors, gas systems, and triggers. And of course, you gotta buy these things in the marketplace. Now, the marketplace, luckily for this game, does not mean marketplace in the sense that you have to spend real cash, but you can just buy guns with the in-game currency. And again, you don't have to buy those, so the game is all self-contained. I can switch to a tactical pump shotgun right here. Unfortunately, those are too expensive, and now there's 2,000 credits, or $2,000 if you will. And you can see that the rest of these are at the moment locked, and the same goes for pretty much all of the other stuff. If I were to look, for example, at optics, some of these optics I can buy, and they can improve my accuracy. Some things will not be available right from the start. So this is how you play this game. It reminds me a little bit about XCOM. It is top-down warfare, and you do it as a turn-based strategy game, or turn-based tactical game, really. So let's start the first mission. This is Operation Swift Caravan, and terrorists have taken over a American-Afghan business trade center with the intention to destroy it. Secure a foothold within the building. Now, let's launch this one. Yeah, I'm not going to play the tutorial. I already know how to play this game. When you first start with the game, you can pick one of two doors. You can either go in through the A door or the B door. So let's call them Alpha, Position, and Bravo. I can pick one to four guys to start at one or two of those doors, so I can set my team up wherever I like them. I got a fire team leader, a weapons sergeant, I got a medic, and a direct action. I can also select my method of entry, so either normal, using a shotgun, using an explosive, but I don't have any explosive, quantity is zero, or lockpicks, again, quantity zero. So I'm gonna go in 2x2. You can see that this is the room that they'll be entering at the Alpha position, and this is Bravo. This looks like a conference room, whereas this looks like a bullpen office park. So I'm gonna send two of my guys in at Alpha and two in at Bravo. Unfortunately, I do not have any of the silent options like lockpicking, so I'm just going to have to go in normally. Team is ready. We're stacked up, and now you can see by all of these circles where my team can go. Now I can click over here, and then I can select where they should be looking. So the first waypoint for my forward guy, who's called Warren, is right over here. He's going to check this angle. This door is closed, so they cannot see through there. So I first want them to clear this side of the room. Once that is clear, I'm going to move him one step to the side, again looking at that target. I then want to turn him around so that he can cover the rest of the room. And once that is clear, I'm going to have him over there. My other guy is going to come into the room as well, but looking the other way. He's going to use the table as cover as much as possible because there might be some guys over there, or the room might be empty. The game is procedurally generated, so you don't exactly know what's going to happen. So you got to cover every angle. The game has one of the slogans, which is "Own every angle," so that's what I intend to do. Now I got Middleton and Barajas over here, and I want him to secure this side of the room. Now with this, I can look into these two circles, but not this one. So if there's a shooter over there, I cannot see him. So I'm going to push up and try and get as deep into this room as possible and try to clear it in one turn. And with this, I can overlook the entire room. Of course, my other guy is going to to go into the other area. The weapons I'm using by now, I believe, are M16s. I'm not entirely 100% on that, but that's what I think they are. And this means that they are not silenced, and you can have those later in the game, which gives you a little tactical advantage. Okay, I got all my units set up. They all have their waypoints. Let's breach it. As you can see, targets around, and they took them all out. They were not hurt in the process, except for Middleton and Barajas, who took some hits. Now, I know that there's a guy over here, and you can see that by these four squares that he is full health. I would like to send this guy in, but it's a bit risky. So instead, I can try to come in from the other angle with this guy, who is Barajas. And like this, I can try and get him. Well, this guy also marches in and tries to get a shot at him. Now keep in mind that these guys do have overlapping fields of fire, and I don't want them to shoot each other. So I'm going to push him in through here. Have him keep looking at the target, and position him like that. While Warren is going to look like this, and then reverse into the room, setting up like this. This gives me James and Middleton to manage, and Middleton is over here. I want him to just have a look into the room. And actually, I want him to have a look like that, so I can cover that area. When he does that, I can have James over here look into the other corner of the room. He's going to come in and cover that angle. And there you go. Breach. Target down. One target over there, and he gets taken out. Now all of this goes down very, very quickly. Got 4 out of 4 stars, but then again, it's the first mission. I just reset my process on it, so here we go. The entire operation, while talking you through, it lasted approximately 2 minutes. The actual gameplay was 6.9 seconds. So in 6.9 seconds, I cleared that room. Now these guys do have a level up system in place, so I can now level up my guys and improve their reaction force, their accuracy, their speed, so how quickly they can move and how far they can move, health, leadership. This is a special element for the team leader, and it boosts the stats surrounding this guy. Or evasion, the chance of evading shots. Now the first thing I want to do is get evasion, or get all stats up to 50. So I'm just going to start with accuracy. My guy Middleton is a weapon sergeant, which means that he is very proficient with weapons. I can use his proficiency to make sure that he does a little bit more damage. He's going to be my damage dealer. Oren James over here is my medic, and that means that I want him to be good at first aid. So I want him to be a little bit better with med packs. My direct action, Trevor Warren, is going to be good at intimidation, and that means that he will take less fire because it's harder to acquire him. There you go, next mission. This situation, I only have the alpha position, only this door. I have one big room here in the middle. I got one room over there and one room over there. They're all connected. They all have doors leading to each other. So I'm going to first have to push my way into this area, and I don't really like this corner because there can be hiding any sorts of, or any number of guys behind that. So we're going to have to pick the alpha door, set up everyone to use that door. And the first guy in is going to have to clear the right side. He is going to push up to the right side and look to the left. And then I want him over there to spot the forward position. Next guy is going to go straight in, but he's going to go to the left flank, overlook this area, set up in this firing position. Middleton is going to go straight in, and he's going to look around that corner and then over there. And finally, Barajas is going to go to this position. Now, I know that they are not all very well in cover. Some of these guys over here are, but especially the last guy, Barajas, is going to be in trouble. So let's see if this works. Target down. Firing on the move, taking down a target, and this guy survives. One of my guys took quite a bit of fire, Middleton, so I'm going to have to move him away. And you can see that I have individual actions for all of these guys now. So I can set them on movement, I can have this guy sprint to a new location. I can have Middleton use a flashbang. I can have him use a med pack on Middleton to heal him up a little bit, but right now I'm just going to pull this guy back to safety. He's going to sit this one out so that he doesn't go down. He can put down fire on this guy, so I'm not going to move him to make sure that he has the best position to fire at him. Actually, I'm going to move him up a little bit. Like that. James over here is going to also provide fire. And I want him to push right into that bad guy. Actually, the last one isn't very good. Oh well, so be it. And I believe that covers all of them, except for this guy, who is gonna... No, he's gonna retreat. Alright, let's do it. Took quite a bit of fire with one of my guys. Took down the bad guy. I cannot see into these rooms, so I don't know if there's anyone in there. Probably is, though. Now, Middleton is taking a ton of fire, so I would like to get my mat pack guy to him. Oh, unfortunately, I have to move this guy first. Normal speed. Go to this side. Go to your buddy. Warren. Cover this door. And you... Actually, you are going to cover that door. Normal speed. Yeah, there used to be a... Oh, sorry, I got the wrong guy selected. Where are you? Yeah, Warren over here. I want Warren actually to cover the other side, but he can't reach that. So I'm just going to do it like that, and then you are going to cover the other side. While these guys are getting healed up. Actually, I could do this a different way, so that these guys don't have to move back. He can go there. I can have Middleton right behind him. So that the next turn they can heal each other up. There you go, door open, but they don't have a shot, they don't have an angle. This guy is in a pretty bad position, and I realize, because his weapon is on the right side. If his weapon was on the left side, he could better fire around the angle of the door. Now let's just toss in a fragmentation grenade over there. Like that. He is going to heal up his buddy. That means that Pendleton cannot move, and I got Barajas over here. I'm just going to park him in the other side of the door for now. Target down. He got hurt, and he takes some fire from him. Now this guy is in a bit of trouble, because I can come at him from two angles. And I will do exactly that. So I want him to take a position on that side of the door. I want you to start laying down fire like that. And for some reason, they didn't heal you up, did they? That's interesting. Unfortunately, no hits yet. let's see, this guy has no actions available except for flashbang, so I'm going to flash this guy. And then I'm going to push in with this guy. Up in the north of the room. Take cover behind the desk. You're going to stay in position, and so are you. He was stunned, and he gets taken down. Of course, graphic-wise, the game isn't very, very interesting. I mean, XCOM looks a lot better. But, tactic-wise, it's nice. It's just a bit of fun. Now you can see that I lost a bit of money over here. I spent 85 on the med pack and the grenade, and another 90 on the frags grenade. A couple of guys leveled up, so they got 5 points again. And we're gonna spend those for him. We were gonna go to 50 on every skill. Guy Middleton of the Navy SEALs. He was my weapon sergeant. More damage. More first aid. And intimidation so that he doesn't get acquired. Next target. Now you can stop this mission whenever you like, so I can just go back to the HQ if you will, and from there I can equip my guys with better weaponry. Now this is a situation where I have four possible entry doors. I got Alpha, Delta, Bravo, and Charlie. This is coming in from the toilets, and with this I can quickly clear this room. But I'm going to have to push out into three directions. I can also come in from Bravo and try to push over there and over there. But this is a pretty open shooting ground. I can come into Alpha, but the corners are not that ideal with all these plants over here and the couches. Or I can come into Delta, and that's what I'm going to do. So I can have overlapping fields of fire from behind these offices. So all of these guys punch in from that side. The first one in the door goes left and then that way. Second one goes right, clears that side, takes up position over there. Third guy pushes up, takes up a position like that. Fourth guy push up and take a position up over there. If there's anyone in front of this door, he's going to be in a hell lot of trouble. No one here. But there is someone over there and over there. Of course, the rest of the rooms I cannot see yet. I can get a UAV, which is weird because the UAV can look into a building. But okay. But that's expensive using UAVs, and I only want to use UAVs if I really don't have a choice, if I really have to know what the hell is going on. So I'm going to have to push these guys up this way. Actually, I'm gonna send this guy the other side. Try and get a shot on him. This guy is going to assist with that, and he's going to the other side of the room, which does put him at quite a bit of risk, but okay. He's gonna take the middle lane. I was gonna send you over there. But your position makes it easier to push up to the other side. And then you can take down this position. Go. Target down, target down. No injuries so far except for Barajas. It's hard to see, by the way, but this slider moved back a little bit. So now we can start to clear these two rooms. And let's do exactly that. I know that there's no guys in here, otherwise I would have heard them. So we're gonna secure this side of the room. First looking in through the doors. And I want these guys to do the same thing. Yep, multiple targets. Exchanging fire, but they're not doing anything to each other just yet. We did a couple of points of damage. Over here, this guy is in a pretty good position, so I'm gonna throw in a flashbang. Now, unfortunately, there is not exactly a wait position, so you have to send your guys out a bit further. And once they are stunned, I can send them back in. So once this guy has been stunned, I can then push into this room. And over here, I cannot do this. Yeah, I can do the same thing actually. Because this guy's going to be hard to nail down. I think that this is the best position for the flashbang because it will stun both of them. And again, I have to send one of these away from the room and then into the room. Yeah, like that, and then looking the other way. Here goes. Flashbang out. Everybody's been stunned. He's got taken down. He's gonna turn around. He's not dead yet. So this guy has to turn around and get Phi onto that target as soon as possible. Same with him. And we're just going to keep pushing that way. Because I know that I'm going to run over this guy like a freight train. I want you to move one sidestep and then take up a position on this side of the door looking that way. Your buddy is going to do the same thing. Look that way. And then look over there. It covers everyone. Target down. Multiple incoming. Target's down. Again, quite a long gameplay, but the actual action took 22 seconds. Now you're going to level up quite a bit in the early stages of the game, but later on this gets harder, of course. And I unlocked the block 11, or block 2. Okay, we're going to push some points into evasion, and for Middleton we're going to push some points into proficiency. First aid and intimidation. Okay, new mission. Large corridor, large hallway if you will, with three separate, I'm not sure what these are, they might be offices or rooms. Yeah, they seem like offices. Quite empty as well. I want to push in from two sides and then go room to room. So I'm going to have two guys at Alpha, two at Bravo, clear this first area, push into the room. Same over there, clear and push in. So we're going to have two at Alpha, and we're going to have two at Bravo. Alright, going through the door, clearing the left flank, and pushing up. The trick to this game is mostly having overlapping fields of fire, making sure you can put a lot of rounds down on target, and try to get into cover. So he's going to go in to the right, clear the more or less left side of the room, have an angle on the left side, and then look around the corner to see if there's anyone over there. Over here it's going to be pretty much the same thing, but in reverse, or mirrored. Now I cannot really get this guy into cover, but I'm going to do it like that, so he's going to cover the rear. This guy is going to push left, push forward, forward, and look around the corner. So here we go. Targets. And no targets around here. So we are pushing up again, having a look into that room like that. And we're going to cross in. So he's going to cross in front of the other guy. This guy's going to look like there, look over there, punch into the room like that, and then cover the room. I had not exhausted his movement points yet. And with tactics like these, you can just fly through the rooms very, very quickly. The thing is that I have to assume that they are such good shooters that they're going to completely eradicate anything that's in their way. Which, if a target is in cover, might not always happen. So let's see how this pans out. Targets in that room. Three targets over there. And I lost two of my guys. So I was a bit too aggressive on that side. Right. We're going to have to move to the other rooms. There was a lot more guys in here than I'd expected. So we're going to take this one a bit more carefully. Clear. No one in there. Which I could say is unfortunate, because I was hoping to take down some guys over there, before I had to take down all of these. Now, I know that going in front of this door is dangerous, but it has to be done. Took two hits there. Still all of these guys are alive. So we're gonna toss in a flashbang. And have the other guy just hold position. Whoops. I want him to hold, and holding increases accuracy, so he's gonna just sit there. Flashbang's in. They're panicked. This guy's down, this guy's down, and the other guy gets taken down as well. Only one star for that, because I lost two of my guys. Now, losing two of your guys does not mean that they're killed permanently. I don't have that feature enabled right now. So I can restart the mission if I want to, making sure that I get more action stars, and with that unlock more levels and more weapons. So that was the first couple of missions for Breach and Clear. Let me know what you think of the game. I think it's still on Steam. I'll put a link to it in the description. It's very cheap. It's just some easy, or relatively easy, action. It does require some tactics and some tactical thinking, but not as much as Wargame, or at least not as much for Wargame for me. So this is what I use to just cool down, do this between games. If I'm bored, I pick up this game and I have some games at it, some missions. So I try to get some money to upgrade my team and stuff like that. So let me know what you think in the comments. If you like this video and like the game, please give it a like. If you want to see more of it, let me know and I will put up more videos. So subscribe to the channel and I'll see you next time.